here. My name is John McEleney. I've been in and around the design and manufacturing business for about 30, almost 35 years. It's 2011, 2012. I'm very good friends with John, and we spent some time together, John Hirschtick, the founder of SolidWorks. And we were talking about how the world had evolved. And we came across Google Body. How many people have ever heard of Google Body? A few. So Google Body, as it suggested, was built by Google. And it was a 3D model of the human body. So you had the skeletal system, the circulatory system, the muscular system. And it allowed you to kind of go and explore the body and have a real 3D interactive experience. A couple of key things about it. There was no software. You could do it from a browser. And when you interacted with that application, it felt like it was a desktop-based system. And for John and myself and the team, for us, that's when the light bulbs, you know, the lights went on and sort of said, the infrastructure is ready. The internet connectivity, WebGL, the browser support, the components were there to allow us to basically look at hitting the reset button and solving some of the fundamental problems that we feel everybody has in design and manufacturing. So when we think about it, design has changed. Everybody here is feeling part of the effects of it. You know, we think about the way that people used to design when I designed 20 years ago. If you had a problem and as a designer in the shop floor had a question, you walk down and you answer the question. Now it's sort of, you know, basically with globalization, you got supply chains throughout the world. Everybody's got huge schedule pressures. It's more and more global. There's more vendors, more customers, more interaction. People are trying to get customer feedback earlier in the process. And every company needs more speed, collaboration, and agility. So we're seeing this on a macro basis. Because we think there are two forces that really create the opportunity. That distributed product design, everybody has the problem how to communicate with many people and many constituencies. And we know that there's a platform shift. Hello, the last major change in this industry in design was 20 years ago. We know because we helped create it. It was in Windows 95 when we started that. Windows 95, a lot's happened since then. Cloud, web, and mobile. And these are huge trends that are affecting every part of your business. And so these two things create the opportunity for speed and innovation. In fact, if you think about businesses, every business wants more speed and more innovation. In the software world, we've responded to that. I don't mean we, meaning Onshape, but the software world. Talk to any software engineer, and they talk about agile software development. How many people have heard of agile software development? Okay, interesting. Because in the hardware world, the whole world of design is going to be transformed in the next 5 years to agile product development. Today, $8 to $10 billion is spent a year on CAD systems. $8 to $10 billion. 100%, well, 99 point something percent, because we haven't really started growing that fast yet, but not, you know, 99 plus percent of them are installed Windows-based desktop solutions, which means the following. Each user has the CAD system. Each user has the data, because the data has to be next to the CAD system to work. When we think about, even if you standardize in a certain CAD system, they all could have different versions of the CAD system, and you can have different versions of the data. So what's happening is you're sending data all over the place, and you're sending it through multiple ways. Email, FTP drives, FTP servers, thumb drives, you name it. But the reality is there's copies of versions. Now, you may be using cloud services, Dropbox, Google Drive. What these really become, they're better, but they become sort of cloud copying machines. So you got more and more copies of your data out there. First thing I'd point to is you got a version problem when this happens. The second thing I'd say to you is if you have any of your InfoSec people here, information security people, anybody who's concerned about security, this is in fact the most insecure system you will find. Any data security analyst will tell you this. The single way to improve your security is reduce the attack area. When you have that many copies flying around, there's all kinds of troubles and challenges. But the reality is this is what we had to do because there was no other way. What we decided to do at Onshape is build a whole new CAD system. We built a whole new CAD system, and we put the CAD system and the data in the cloud. We made it fully accessible on any browser and fully accessible on any mobile device. When you're dealing with a mobile device, it's a full CAD system on that mobile device. You don't have the issue of versioning. Because in fact, you're looking at the same data. There is only one copy of that data in the cloud. Every modern CAD system that's out there, every management system, is a CAD system and a data management layer to make sure that you don't have organizational chaos. When we started Onshape, we thought about it differently. And we started and said, let's build this collaboration and data management system at the core, and we'll wrap a CAD system around it. There is no save button in Onshape. No save button. There are virtually no crashes in Onshape. Inside of a CAD system, you have a lot of components or things that make up the CAD system. One of them happens to be the geometric modeling engine. A modeling engine, think of it, it's almost like the engine in your car. When you go and make an intersection of two cylinders, like the thing that's doing that calculation in SolidWorks, in an NX and in Solid Edge, is something called Parasolid. And it's also doing that inside of Onshape, because we use Parasolid as well. So it's completely compatible with all the other systems. When we looked at building Onshape and building a modern cloud, one CAD system in the cloud, we said we're gonna have a modeling service, treat everything as a service. So we have multiple copies of Parasolid right up there. So if that same exception gets thrown because of a confluence of bad events, if it looks like it's gonna bring down, like that would be a single point of failure, we just point you to another copy of Parasolid. Because it's treating it as a modeling service, not as just this engine. And so as a result, it's inherently much, much more stable. Don't believe me, just go to our forums and read it. You can see it. And it's not just because, it's because architecturally it's fundamentally different because it's a cloud-based solution. How many times do you hear about Salesforce going down? Very, very rarely. These are incredibly robust and reliable systems.